Dear colleagues and dear friends, first of all, I would like to thank you for this invitation and the opportunity to attend and share my message here during the announcement of the 2021 Class of EuropeIndia40 Leaders list compiled by Europe Indian Center for Business and Industry. As the chairman for the European Parliament's Delegation for Relations with India, it's a big honor for me to congratulate young leaders in the European Union-Indian corridor who are doing great work in promoting relations between India and the European Union. EuropeIndia40, an initiative of the EICBI, which is in its third year to discover top 40 under 40 Europe-Indian leaders, covers the story of young leaders and their contributions in promoting European Union-India relations and UK-India relations. During this discussion, I would like to look at the future with hope as India and EU gets ready to celebrate 60 years of diplomatic relations in the year 2022. There is a need to unleash the potential for more trade between India and the European Union over the next few years. Now, the European Union is India's largest trading partner, but India is only the European Union's 10th largest trading partner. Therefore, I believe that this provides a huge potential for European companies in India who are keen to tap opportunities in the Indian market. I would also like to highlight the fact that global trade has increased the living standard for all and will still be one of the main drivers of the much needed growth for all of us. Therefore, the trade between India and the European Union will not only benefit the relations between both, but will give the European companies a greater opportunity to enter the Indian market. India shares many values with the European Union, which makes India seem like a natural partner for the European Union. The outcome of the EU-Indian summit in May, held at Portugal between the European Union and India, have also added a new chapter in relations between the two largest democracies in the world. The fact that two sides met in their first ever EU plus 20 leaders meeting format were not just the European Commission and Council, but also 27 European heads of states of governments were present to meet with Indian Prime Minister Modi virtually sent out a clear political message of the importance Indian and EU attached to their partnership. The extension of this rarely used format to India signals the importance Brussels now attaches to the EU-India partnership. The European Union and India need to work closely to achieve a climate-neutral economy, given that India produces many of the goods that the rest of the world relies on, which naturally has a huge impact on global emissions, along with its share size of the population. This provides an opportunity for those EU companies to explore working with Indian companies to promote and sell green and climate-neutral solutions. The European Union recognizes the opportunities in India, and the next generation of leaders are the ones who need to take forward the work done by the current generations of leaders. I'm glad that the European Indian Center for Business and Industry has recognized this aspect, and a list like EuropeIndia40 Leaders list help young leaders to showcase their work to a wider audience. Once again, I would like to congratulate the 2021 class of EuropeIndia40 leaders. I wish you all the best to all of you. Thank you.